was a 51-year-old school teacher and mother of two adult children, Sally and Owen. She had been married 3 times and described as a romantic type who liked antiques, art, and the opera. She was said to be a good friend, and she wanted a man in her life. Marion lived in Queensland, Australia, working at a private school. There is evidence that she was not happy in her job from late 1996. Between April and June 97, she quit her job, sold her house, and left for Europe to travel. She had no return date and no itinerary. Family and friends initially received phone calls from her in the UK. Then she vanished. The last known sighting of Marion is June 23rd, just before leaving Australia. In June, days before Marion left, her daughter Sally and her fiancé saw Marion out with a man they did not recognize. When Sally asked her mother who the man was, Marion said it was someone she met at the art center. Sally became concerned in October when her mother failed to phone her son, Owen, for his birthday, which was very out of character. After contacting Marion's bank, Sally learned that her mother, or perhaps someone else, had been draining her bank account for maximum daily limits over August and September 1997. Sally then began her own investigation to find her mother, since the police thought Marion had intentionally disappeared of her own accord. Sally found that prior to leaving, Marion changed her name to Florabella Remacle and did not tell anyone. She obtained a new passport in this name. The surname Remacle is uncommon, and only one man lived in Luxembourg was found with his name. On June 23rd, Marion filled an outbound passenger card in her new name, saying she was destined for Luxembourg. Then Marion came back to Australia on August 2nd, saying she lived in Luxembourg and ticking a box saying she was married. Passenger cards appear to be written by Marion herself, yet postcards also written by Marion from the UK continued to arrive to her family and friends past this date. Marion last spoke to Sally on August 1st in a telephone call which seemed very ordinary and showed no signs of distress. Marion said she was phoning from Tunbridge Wells, UK, but given the dates and passenger card, it's concluded that Marion was either phoning from Hong Kong Airport or an impersonator was on the flight back to Australia. After her supposed return to Australia in August, money continued to drain out of her account from banks near to where she used to live. Her car insurance was cancelled, and she used her Medicare card at an optometrist. After that, the trail went cold. There has been no activity from Florabella Remacle or Marion Barter anywhere. An inquest into Marion's disappearance and suspected death began in 2021 and continued in February 2022. Quest featured the evidence of a man called Rick Plum. Rick Plum had up to 30 different names and was the same man who had taken a new identity of Fernand Remacle. This was not the same Fernand Remacle from Luxembourg. Under a different name, he says he had 2 brief affairs with Marion Barter. First in the 1960s, then again in 1970. before she disappeared. Yet he denies any knowledge of what happened to Marion. This man used false identities to commit fraud. Evidence in the inquest also